So I wanted to do a bit of a life update. So it's been a while since I've sat down and had a proper chat with you guys. I feel like I haven't done a vlog in a while, although I am filming a vlog for this week. I wanted to have a little sit down chat and a little bit of a life update, because the last 2 weeks have been wild. Absolutely wild. I definitely want to sit down and do more of these chats, because I feel like my goals for 2020 are progressing a lot faster than I ever expected, and I want to bring you along for the ride of that. If you follow my Instagram page, you would have seen that we hit some pretty crazy milestones when it comes to YouTube. Obviously, if you've watched my videos on my income streams, which I'll talk about soon, I mentioned in that video one of my goals for 2020 was to get monetized on YouTube, and we've already hit one of the requirements. So to get monetized on YouTube, you need 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. I've already hit the 1,000 subscribers and I'm over a quarter of the way to the watch time, which is crazy, absolutely crazy. In this video, I wanna run you through like a bit of an update of like where I'm at with like my income streams, how business is going, all of that sort of stuff. So I guess we start chatting about it. In my video where I spoke about my 11 new sources of income, I spoke very openly about my goals to expand the balloon business. And my reasoning for wanting to do that was basically because we were quiet. And that was because no events were happening. Prior to COVID, every week we would be booking events for future dates. And every time someone books an event with us, we take a 50% deposit. So each week we're bringing in money from people booking events, leaving deposits. And then before their event happens, we take the other 50% of the order. So money's like constantly rolling in. When COVID hit, that completely stopped. And that was why in that video, I spoke about doing daily deliveries. We now do daily deliveries and it is going 10 times better than I ever thought it would. When I first decided to do the helium daily deliveries, I was actually kind of nervous because I was like, there's just, I don't know. If you know what I'm like, I think of worst case scenario. And so in my head, I was like, oh, it's gonna be a pain. Like, what if people aren't home? What if, what is our process then? Do we have to bring it back here? Do we re-deliver? Do we charge for the re-delivery? Like, what do we do? But the more I looked into it, the more I'm like, I create these processes. So I create the processes that work best for us as a business while also ensuring that we have customer satisfaction and that they're aware of those processes. So then we started doing daily deliveries. I edited all of our website, uploaded products, and slowly orders started to trickle in. But then very quickly it's picked up and I'm doing minimum 4 or 5 deliveries a day. But also we've got a lot of people booking dates in advance. So I'm thinking it's gonna get really busy really quick, to the point where I'm actually considering now, like, do I need to hire a driver? Maybe I should roll this back a bit. I'll give you an insight to what my daily life looks right now. Most mornings I wake up and me and Buds go for a walk. It's just like a really nice way to sort of start the day. And then I usually go home, have a shower, pack food to come up here and have lunch or breakfast or whatever I'm doing, and then get straight into work. Most of my mornings are filled with admin, which might be responding to balloon orders, packing balloon orders, filming for YouTube or TikTok. And I'm gonna discuss TikTok in a minute because that is a massive part of the last 2 weeks of my life that has literally skyrocketed all of my goals to happening a lot quicker than I ever thought they would. With the balloon orders though, something that I saw as an issue when we first started was I wanna make sure that people can order for same day up until 12 p.m. and then from 12 p.m. till 2 p.m. I do the deliveries, just so it gave my day some structure, because I didn't want orders coming through at 3 o'clock or 10 a.m. and then still having to deliver them. I wanted it to be set in stone, automated and process driven. So that's what it does. Now if someone comes to my website and it's before 12 o'clock, they can select the same day. If they order from past 12 o'clock, they can't select that same day for delivery, but then they can select any other day in the calendar for delivery. So usually I start making up balloons around like 11:30-ish, and then depending on how many orders we've got, then I go and do the deliveries, and I usually finish my deliveries around 2. Sometimes if I've got a lot of deliveries in the same area, I'll wait till around 1 o'clock and then I'll go and smash them all out, get them all delivered, and then I'm back in the office by 2. I'm finding though, like, I have so much stuff that I want to get done for 2020. Like, okay, I think we need to talk about TikTok, because TikTok is like a big part of my life update. I first downloaded TikTok back in March and I started it under a completely different profile, like not under my own name. It was just something that, like, I don't know about you guys, but when I first went into lockdown last So when I went into lockdown the first time back in March, I started cleaning everything. I was time-lapse cleaning, time-lapse cooking. I was like cleaning everything. Every area of the house was cleaned and I filmed them. I find time-lapses really soothing. So I started a time-lapse TikTok account and uploaded some videos. And then I just sort of found myself sitting on TikTok looking at other stuff as like, it's kind of like social media, you end up sitting there scrolling for hours on end. Randomly, a couple of my videos did really well. Like I remember one getting up to 10,000 views and I was like, whoa, like that's crazy. I've connected with 10,000 people. My followers grew, but I didn't really understand it. I wasn't really invested in it. I was going through the emotional roller coaster of isolation. And for me, the first round of isolation was quite difficult. I did enjoy it, but at the same time, it was so out of my usual routine. I'm so used to being busy all the time and having different projects to work on. But when the first isolation happened, my balloon business, we fully closed. The lash business, I fully closed. I'd just come back from Bali, so I'd been in like a holiday mode and kind of ready to work, and then had to do nothing for 6 weeks. So it was kind of a really weird time in my life. I'm so grateful for it because I really got to know more about myself, which, I mean, I thought I knew everything, but it definitely made me realize what I want from life and where I want my life to be and what I want to be doing and who I want in my life. And then also my income streams. Like I thought I had these two great businesses, lashes and balloons, which could withstand anything, and that I could do my balloon bookings from anywhere in the world, be working from my laptop and be booking in lash clients from anywhere in the world. But when the pandemic hits, no one's booking anything in. So kind of changed everything, and that's where I had to pivot the business and do the daily deliveries. So back to TikTok. I can't remember when I first started my personal account, but I'm assuming I'll insert it in the screen. So whatever that date is there, that's when I first started. And I didn't tell anyone. It was something that I was, I'm not like shy or awkward about, but it wasn't something that I was promoting because I still didn't really know what I was doing. And then I just started posting more and more. And then there was a couple of weeks where I didn't post anything. I didn't really see the value in it. I hadn't started doing YouTube yet. And then once I started doing YouTube, I sort of started posting more. And I mean, I had a few videos do really well. Like I had videos get over 20, 30,000 views. And then I had some get up to like 100,000 and then some get to like 300,000. And then I had one that absolutely took off. It has, I think when I'm filming this video, it has like 8 million views and over 1.5 million likes, heaps of comments, and it just exploded. When a video goes viral, it's not that it just goes viral overnight, it continues going viral for ages. Like still now, which is over a week later, it's still bringing in heaps, like thousands and thousands of views each day. But I just continued posting. So I continued posting, continued uploading, started doing some TikTok lives, which I actually really enjoy. I really like that I can interact with a following directly. And everything just changed. My Instagram account grew, my YouTube watch hours grew, my YouTube subscribers grew, everything started to grow, and I started to build this community around myself. And the same with TikTok though, I feel like there's lots of little things that I was doing that a lot of people don't know about, or a lot of people don't know how to use TikTok. My sisters have reached out. I've got friends that have reached out being like, how do you actually do this? How did you do that? How did you add text? How do you set the duration for text? How do you add music? Can you do a voiceover? All these questions. So I guess this kind of goes back to like my income source video where I spoke about doing ebooks, and a couple of ebooks that I want to bring out this year. The first one is how to do TikTok. I am in the midst right now of building an ebook on how to do TikTok. I'm not really sure what the title is going to be. I don't want it to be something like how to go viral on TikTok, because there is no surefire way of going viral on TikTok. The TikTok algorithm is wild, but you do have a high chance of going viral if you follow my tips. And I genuinely mean that. I feel like I've figured out ways to grow a following and engage with a following to better your chances of going viral on TikTok. So what I'm currently working on is that ebook, which also, not only is it an ebook, it's also gonna provide whoever buys my ebook is also gonna have access to a private Facebook page where I'm gonna show screen recordings of how I do all of my TikTok. So how I clip them together, sounds, how to do voiceovers, how to do anything. I'm gonna do screen recordings of those just to make it super easy, because I think think a lot of people find TikTok overwhelming and don't really know what to put out, how to put it out, how does it show on the screen. So I kind of want to help with all of that. And I think this ebook could be really helpful. I also think it could be a fantastic passive income source. It's obviously taking me a while to get the ebook all together because I want to have as much information in there as possible. But I think once it's done, it's going to be fantastic. And I know that it will help a lot of people. I have watched businesses completely transform purely from their TikTok following, from people following their accounts and seeing how they started their business, what they sell, to doing these like pre-order launches and selling out of their pre-order stock. Like, it's crazy. TikTok is phenomenal and I absolutely love the platform. Another ebook that I'm working on for 2020 is, it's gonna be along the lines of how to know if your business idea is profitable. I think a lot of people start a business and they get really excited about all the stuff they're gonna need and what they're gonna sell and who their target market is, but they don't look at their profit margins, and profit margins are the most important part of having a business. If your business isn't profitable enough to cover all of your expenses plus your time and wages if you need staff, your business isn't profitable. And for every business that I've started, this is something that I do at the start. If you've watched my other videos, this was something I learned massively from my period parcels. I basically had a very profitable business model, and then right at the end, after I'd purchased absolutely everything, I had everything ready to go, I went to Australia Post and was like, yep, I want those bags that I'd found for like, I think I'd found them for like $8. And they're like, oh, your thing won't fit in that, it's too heavy. And that just brought everything crumbling down because I hadn't done the proper due diligence that I needed to do. And what I thought was gonna be an $8 spend for delivery costed about $16. So that's an $8 chunk out of my profit margins on a parcel, which is huge. So yeah, I wanna come out with some sort of ebook that helps people with the calculations of like figuring out your profit, how to factor in time, that type of thing. That's definitely something I'm working on. But for now, the first ebook that I'm gonna come out with is how to do TikTok and how TikTok can help you grow your personal brand, your business, or if you just, I don't know, maybe you've got a passion that you love doing, and I know I speak a lot about this in all of my videos, but say if you've got a passion for knitting, you just absolutely fucking love knitting. Knitting can be done anywhere in the world. You could be on holidays and you could be knitting. If you can build a following around you for your knitting, you could make money off that. You can make money off anything. It's just about putting in the time and being dedicated to something. And I think TikTok is a phenomenal platform for growth. The other thing that TikTok has helped me do is to build up my Instagram following, which then allows me to reach out to brands. Not only is like my Instagram following great, but my TikTok following right now, as of today, which, okay, what's today's date? Today's date is Tuesday the 18th and it's 12:54 p.m. Right now on TikTok, I have, I'm gonna take a screenshot. 148,000 TikTok followers, 2.5 million likes. That is crazy. That alone gives me backing that I can go to brands and say, look, I have this following. Every video that I upload gets an average of, I would say probably around 10,000 views plus. Actually, it's probably a lot higher than 10,000 when you weigh out all the videos that have gone viral, because multiple of my videos have. And yeah, I can't wait to work with brands. I spoke about this on my Instagram page the other day where, I wonder if I can insert that. Do I have it? I want to talk about influencing really quickly because I think there's a lot of people that don't really understand influencing, and I want to explain why I want to get into it. And I had to think about it, and there's two main reasons. If you haven't already realized, I'm a pretty creative person. And not only that, but if you're close to me and you know what I'm like, you know that my mind is always constantly running with like different business ideas or like different ways to promote things. And I just feel like, I don't know, I think influencing would be a really good way to get paid for my creativity and like helping brands to grow. And then, yeah, I just think it would be a job. I think it would be really cool that I can work for myself and then help brands grow whilst being creative. Like, yeah, so that's reason number one. And number two is it is incredibly profitable. If you've watched all of my YouTube videos, there's a video I did on dropshipping. And when I had that business, I actually selected influencers that I wanted to work with, reached out to them, went through all the process, and then paid them money to promote our products. So I have an insight into how like the whole influencer marketing
gig sort of works, but I also have an insight to like the fucking money that they're making for promoting products. And also, some of the influencers that I work with were fucking shit. Like, they were so bad at promoting the product. They were so like, I don't know. Anyway, I think I could work really well with brands because I have a business mindset, but I'm also like really creative. And I think join them together and I think it will be really, really fun. So they're the reasons that I want to get into like the influencer side of things.
So yeah, as that said, I'm pretty creative. I love the idea that I have a business mind whilst also having like a creativity mind. And I think bringing them together and being able to work with brands whilst also earning a decent amount of money from it is such a great idea. And I'm so excited to do that. And literally TikTok has allowed me to do that a lot sooner than I thought I would, because I've now been able to grow my following, start seeing if I can work with brands. I do want to say thank you to my friend Casey, who's built me a media kit. If you're not sure what a media kit is, it's basically something that you can send to brands that has all of your analytics of all of the social media platforms that you use, and it's just a really good way for brands to see who you reach and how you reach them. Something else I'm working on for 2020 is my balloon course. I have had heaps of messages for people that are interested, but I will eventually get to that down the track. I hope you've enjoyed this little catch up. If you do have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, I'll see you in my weekly vlog, which will be uploaded soon. Thanks for watching.